say that it is really very encouraging for us as TB workers to come into a situation where we are now sighting the end of TB. About a decade back, we never even could imagine that TB could come to an end, and we were all struggling when the RNTCP came up to think about controlling TB. Now, with the coming of end of the Millennium Development Goals in 2015, a thinking has emerged that yes, we at the global level and specifically India at the country level has achieved the two most important components of the Millennium Development Goal, which is reducing the prevalence of disease by half and reducing the mortality due to tuberculosis by half. After having achieved the goals on mortality and prevalence, the next challenge is to reduce the incidence of disease. That is, the patients who are coming to us on a year-to-year basis should also reduce. Though the reduction has started, but the rate of reduction is very slow, and hence intensified efforts are needed to, in fact, reduce the incidence. With this background in mind, I would say the world has now started to think of ending the TB epidemic with the main objectives that the mortality should really become zero deaths. And the goal is that by, say, 2035, we should have reduced the mortality by 95%. Similarly, the incidence of the disease, that is the number of cases coming every year, should also undergo a rapid decline. And within this period, it should reduce by 90%. So if we have to achieve these two most important components, definitely our efforts also need to be energized. And if we are able to achieve this, then automatically, you see, the catastrophic costs would be reduced, which is the third aim of the end TB strategy. Because as the patients reduce, the costs which are incurred by the families on the management of tuberculosis will also reduce. And government is taking steps in that direction. The specific steps which I would talk of are, number one is that they are working towards enhancing case detection. Because if you have to reduce incidence, you have to catch the infectious TB patients early in all parts of the community and put them on effective treatment so that they become non-infectious and the transmission of the disease is checked. This is being done by not only limiting our case detection to passive case finding, but for an active search in communities, in societies like old age homes, malnourished children, slum populations, jhuggi jhopadi colonies. Their active search amongst the community is being done to search out tuberculosis. Then for marginalized populations, this search is also intensified. In addition to doing just sputum microscopy, we are having more modern technologies like molecular techniques. CBNAT is being used, line probe assay is being used, which will give the result very rapidly, say within a span of a few hours, and not only give the result of TB, but also indicate whether the organism is resistant or sensitive to the most commonly used drug, that is rifampicin. With early diagnosis and prompt treatment, we would be in a position to reduce the infectiousness within the community, and that will automatically lead to a reduction in the incidence of the disease. This cannot be done by government alone, that is very clear. Partnerships have to be sought, and these partnerships should be not only with the private sector, not only with the NGOs, but partners even within the government. Ministries other than health ministry will have to join hands. Ministries of social development will have to join hands. We'll have to focus on better nutrition. We'll have to focus on industry to reduce pollution. All these things will have to go hand in hand. We'll have to work with NGOs. And it is only with a combined effort that we will be able to achieve universal access and treatment for tuberculosis. As is very clear that if you diagnose the disease early and treat it effectively, mortality would always go down. So it is quite apparent that with this effort, of good quality diagnosis, of expanded treatment opportunity, your mortality of the disease target of reducing it to zero would happen. You see, I would say the first thing is that at the program and policy level, there has to be a renewed priority for this particular direction. And funding which is being given to the program should be enhanced, because each of these activities which I mentioned, of active case detection, newer diagnostic tools, better treatment modalities, all will cost money. So until and unless fund flow is adequate, fund flow is easy, accessibility to funds is easy, it will not happen. So this is a big challenge for the government in the current scenario, to not only enhance fund allocation, but to ensure that the fund reaches the place where it is required. I would say that would be one of the major challenges. The second major challenge is within the profession, there should be adequate dissemination on the guidelines. What is the standard of care for treating TB should be well brought out to all professional associations, to all doctors, so that they diagnose TB as per the standard of care, treat TB as per the standard of care. That means within professional communities, we have to work harder. Within general community, in society at large, we have to give messages which will work towards reducing transmission. Simple things: cover your mouth while coughing, don't spit here and there, take your treatment for the full duration. These are the messages which will really promote your TB care within the community. If you have symptoms of TB, go to the nearest health facility. Government gives you best of diagnosis, best of treatment, free of cost. Please avail these facilities. So these are the things within the community which one can do. One should not lose any opportunity to address the community, to address the professionals in this regard. That we go to certain population groups like HIV, like diabetic clinics, like old age homes, the geriatric clinics, geriatric population, and screen them on a regular basis. Healthcare workers working in any hospital should be screened, because they are at greater risk of developing the disease. So this screening has to be done more effectively in order to catch the TB patients early. And definitely not only make the facility available, but it should be accessible to the patient also, you know. It should be to the patient's convenience. So patient-centered approach will have to be really done, so that the patient approaches the health facility. Just giving a facility is not the answer, but patients have to access that facility. That will have to be ensured. And when you do a networking wherein any TB patient who is diagnosed is at least notified, then definitely it will be the onus of the government to see that this notified TB patient gets the proper treatment till the patient gets cured for the full duration. So that will become again a government responsibility. So with better notification, I think we will achieve some more effort in terms of compliance. I will say that end TB is a reality. We must understand it, and we owe it to the coming generation to end it in this generation.